Good morning, children. How are you all? Enjoying? Yes, very good, but be healthy. Eat properly. Play properly and also learn. Okay? Now today we are going to learn another lesson from English Reader. A pouch for Joey. That's the name of the lesson. What is the name of the lesson? A pouch for the Joey. You know what is the meaning of Joey? So Joey means this is a kangaroo's baby. Okay? Joey means kangaroo's baby. How dog's baby we call it as puppy, isn't it? We call it as puppy. Mama's baby we call it as kid, right? So, like that, a kangaroo's baby, right? Kangaroo's baby is called Joy. Okay? So, Joy, right? A pouch for Joy. You know that kangaroo will be having a pouch, right? Have you ever seen that kangaroo having a pouch? I'll show you. Yes, this is the kind of the pouch that kangaroo will be having so that it can keep the Joy, its kid, in the pouch. And right then it can carry along with her. Right? So this is how kangaroos are made or created. And now the story is about how kangaroo got this pouch. Okay? How kangaroo got this pouch. So let us see how it got the pouch. So this is a story about a mother kangaroo and a baby Joy. Right? So this Joy and mother kangaroo, they were living in a jungle. You know what is a jungle? It's a forest where all the animals live there, and everywhere there will be trees and plants, right? Big trees, right? And here mother kangaroo was worried about Joy always. Why? Because without informing mother, baby Joy used to go, hop and hop and go everywhere in the forest, right, without telling mother. And see, when you go out of the home without telling mother, is the mother worried? Yes or no? Yes. Like, similarly, like that only, even kangaroo also, the mother kangaroo also is very much worried about Joy. Okay? So now let us see what it is. Joy, where are you? Called mother kangaroo, looking for her son. Come here now. So she was calling out the Joy. So Joy, where are you? And come here now. Mother kangaroo looked around the bushes but could not see her Joy. So now she started searching for Joy in the bushes around, right? And that boy is too naughty, she mumbled to herself. He is always hopping off. So she was saying mumbled. Mumbled means also we can say that murmuring, said something not so clear, right? But within, like not opening the mouth totally. See, even when we are not seen, mummies will be talking within themselves. So nobody can hear it, but mothers will be talking in themselves and searching where this boy has gone. Re, bapre, heavy traffic, and I don't know where this boy is. Like that, is not with worried tone, mothers will be talking to themselves. Like that, here even she was mumbling. She mumbled to herself, he is always hopping off. You know the meaning of hop, jump, right? Frogs also hop, kangaroo also hops. Right? So, and he is always hopping off. Off in the sense, OFF means he is going off, hopping off. He always leaves me and goes out. Using her paw, she shaded her eyes from the bright sun and looked around for her Joy again. So, the day was very bright. The sun is very hot. Right? And therefore she shaded her eyes. You know how, what is meant by shading her eyes? Like keeping hand on the eyes, right? So that the bright sun rays do not fall in our eyes. Like that, is it not? Even we do it when we want to see some higher places. right? Then we will be keeping fingers or the hand on our eyes, and then try to see that. Let we try to shade. We try to shade our eyes, like from hot sun. So like that, she also looked around for joy again. "Here I am," an excited voice called out from behind her. And Joy, he is so excited, so happy, so thrilled. And he came and he said, "Here I am." "Ah," Mother Kangaroo hopped 6 feet in the air and landed with a thud. So immediately by seeing the child, now she is very much relaxed, right? So she just hopped for 6 feet and then she landed with a thud. What do you mean by thud? A heavy sound, like when something falls heavily on floor, then you will be getting this thud sound, right? So she landed with a thud. "Joy, you frightened me," she said. So what did she say to Joy? "You frightened me. How can you go like that without telling me?" "Sorry, mother," said Joy. "That's all right," she answered, rubbing his head fondly. "But you shouldn't hop off alone. It can be dangerous." So rubbing his head fondly. Fondly means very likingly. Is not mother loves a baby so much, right? So she was rubbing his head fondly, likingly. And then she said, "Now see, please, that's all right. It's okay now. But next time you don't do that. You should not hop off alone. You cannot go alone like that. It can be dangerous." Why do you think it can be dangerous? Because, tell me why. Yes, tigers, lions will be there. Wild animals will be there. They may eat off this baby kangaroo, that is Joy. Or he may fall off a cliff. See, very mountains, hills, everything will be there also. Like unknowingly, it may fall off. So then it will get injured, right? Wounded. So it will get hurt. So that is why mother was saying that it is dangerous. You don't go all alone. "But mother, there are so many exciting things to see. I get bored standing here eating grass." So what is he saying? Joy is saying, right? "But mother, there are so many exciting things." Exciting means very, very interesting things to see. "And really I get bored by standing here and eating only grass." "That grass is good for you," said Mother Kangaroo. "Now be a good Joy and don't go hopping off again." So now she is saying that grass is good for you. You have to eat. And now for now don't go again anywhere. And be here. Be a good baby. She put her head down and started munching the sweet grass. Now she engaged herself in eating the grass. Right. When she looked up, she couldn't see Joy. So again the same. So she was eating grass, bending her head down. As she looked up again, she cannot find Joy there. She gave a big sigh. Sigh means like that, right? Sigh means a deep sound that will be produced by a person like when they are disappointed, right? Sigh and started looking for him again. Right. Up ahead, she saw the leaves on a bush shaking. Suddenly, she saw leaves on a bush shaking. "Ah, that's my Joy." So, she thought that it was her Joy. She said, she hopped over quickly and bumped into a fat old wombat. So, when she just jumped into the bush. So, when she jumped into the bush, she knocked a fat old wombat. What is a wombat? It's an Australian animal similar to a small bear. It looks like a bear. It's but not a bear, but it's a small, like a small bear it looks. So what is its name? Wombat. So now when she jumped into the bushes, she could see that it is not Joy, but it is a fat old wombat. It's old, right? It's not a baby. Even though it is small, it looks like a baby, but it is old wombat. Okay, she just knocked her out. Like means she went there and she hit. So, because she didn't see, no, with much speed, she jumped there and she had hit or knocked the fat old wombat. Now, in the next class, we will see what happened afterwards. See you again, children. And now look at the hard words. Mumbled, said something not clear or loud enough. Frightened, made mother kangaroo afraid. Dangerous, something that can harm. Munching, eating noisily like nom nom nom, right? Wombat, an Australian animal similar to a small bear. So these are the hard words that we have come across in today's lesson. So children, learn the spellings of these hard words as well as the meanings. Give a reading to the lesson. Is it interesting? Is it not? Can you see the a kangaroo talking to her joy? Yes. So this is a beautiful forest. You can see it's a bug. It's a caterpillar here. Very interesting, is it not? Alright, and the joy is here. And this is kangaroo. Right, mother kangaroo. So very interesting story, is it not? So okay, let's meet again.